In today's video, we are going to be taking a look at the Tatcha Violet C Radiance Mask. Hello, hello! Welcome back to my channel. It's so good to see you again. So, we are testing out the Tatcha Violet C Radiant Mask. So, if you guys have seen my recent Lustworthy makeup products video, I was talking about how I was really excited about this. I love everything Tatcha. This does retail for about $68. It is quite expensive up there with what I would consider like luxury skincare, but I just couldn't resist. I wanted to give it a try, and I can be the guinea pig for all of you guys who are wondering if it's really worth it. Just to let you guys know, obviously this is like a different vibe to this video. This is late at night. I was just about to go to bed and I was like, oh my gosh, I should film a first impression. So, you know, I'm already ready to go to bed. I've already got my hair, my wig off, you know, hair is wrapped up. And I took out my contacts. So I want to read to you guys the instructions. So let me put on my glasses. Okay. I'm looking like a teacher, like a professor, huh? So on the side, it says that this mask has 7 mild AHA fruit acids to turn over dead, uneven skin and help improve clarity, which is awesome. Also has vitamin C, of course, which is gonna brighten the skin, give you that nice glow. It has Japanese beauty berry, which helps boost and stabilize vitamin C, which is awesome because it can, I think, expire quickly if it's not kept in the right conditions. And it has something called Hada C3, a trinity of anti-aging Japanese superfoods, restores a healthy looking youthful radiance. Now, you guys, I am all about that. So, you are supposed to apply it to cleansed skin. So let me go ahead and do that. I'm going to go ahead and wash my face with my little Clarisonic Fit, and then I'm gonna be right back. Okay, so when you open it up here, you do get 1.7 fluid ounces. It comes in this lovely packaging, which is super cute. They also include some background about the product, how to use it on this sheet. And then you get the infamous Tatcha spoon, which is supposed to simulate gold, to look like gold. This is actually really common. A lot of Korean skincare brands come with these little spoons, so that's more sanitary. You just scoop it out and then apply it to your face and spread it. Ooh, and look at this awesome purple gooiness. So to be honest with you guys, as much as I like the spoon, I have this little face mask spatula thing from Bon Vivant, and I like it a lot better because it's easy to clean and it helps me kind of spread it out evenly. So that's what I'm going to be using because I don't want to waste a single drop of this stuff. So it's actually like super thick on here, and ooh, doesn't really smell like much, that's for sure. But it's nice and thick, which I'm not used to with a vitamin C mask. So this is what it looks like when it's all on. I love the color. I love purple, you guys. Like, purple's my favorite freaking color. So to have a purple mask, that's like a dream come true for me. But seriously, it doesn't really feel like much. It doesn't tingle. It just looks purple. I'm supposed to leave this on for 15 minutes and then rinse off. They do say that you can use this about 2 to 3 times a week. So I'm gonna come back after I've rinsed this off, and then I'll show you guys what I kind of do for the rest of my nighttime skincare. And then I'll just talk about my thoughts and my first impressions with you guys. Okay guys, so I'm back. Now, my face is nice and clean. I did notice when I did rinse it off, it was super moisturized. The actual mask didn't like dry down like a clean mask. It stayed pretty, you know, just like wet and moist. So that's good. I mean, I feel like my skin feels amazing. Now, next what I'm gonna do is I'm going to mist my face with this Evan Healy Rose Geranium Facial Tonic Hydrosol Spray. So good for your skin. And it smells heavenly. What I like to do is I just like push this into my skin. If you guys haven't tried rose hydrosol for your face, like, it's amazing. It moisturizes your face. Even if you have oily skin, it helps to kind of balance your skin out. It also helps combat fine lines, and it is just amazing, especially when you combine it with rose oil. So now that that's done and it's mostly evaporated and kind of the rest has sunk into my skin, I'm taking a break from my Drunk Elephant glycolic serum, and I'm trying out something new, The Ordinary. This is their hyaluronic acid treatment, and it's got 2% acid, and it also has B5 vitamins, and it comes with this nice little dropper. I love their packaging. Their packaging is amazing. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put like 2 to 3 drops on my hands and kind of pat it in. So when that goes on, it just kind of leaves my skin just a tiny bit tacky, but otherwise I like it. I mean, 3 drops is like more than enough to cover the face. Maybe you might want 1 to 2 drops for your neck as well. And moving on to my night cream, I'm using the Tatcha Supple Moisture Rich Silk Cream. It's also really, really great if you have oily skin, oily combination skin. It works for a bunch of different skin types, and this is how much I'm using. And I just like to lightly kind of put it on my skin. Now, trust me guys when I say that moisturizer is amazing. I just love it so much. And I just smooth it onto my skin. And I just like, you know, pat the excess in and just leave it. And I'm ready to go to bed just like this. Now, of course, before I go to bed, I want to talk to you guys about the vitamin C mask right here. You know, I really like it. I think it's the kind of thing where you just have to, like, use it continuously 2 to 3 times a week to see noticeable difference. This is my first time and I don't see anything noticeable. It did leave my skin nice and moisturized. Like, that I will say is amazing, and I'm so happy about that. And I'm excited to continue using it. There wasn't anything that I honestly didn't like about the foundation. I found it very pleasant. It didn't smell like anything in particular. It was very thick. I will say that next time I'm going to use a smaller amount because it was harder to rinse off. I had to use a washcloth to really, like, just get everything out of there so there weren't any purple bits, you know, left on my face. But I do like it a lot and I will continue to use it. And I definitely think that it's worth the $68. Now, of course, you definitely have to be somebody that's into nice skincare, like quality skincare, to actually use this. If you don't care that much about skincare, you're not into it, then this is not going to be a product for you. But I definitely think that the products have great ingredients. I have sensitive skin. It didn't irritate my skin at all. So I'm really, really happy. I'm going to have to say 2 thumbs up from me. Now let me know, you guys, have you used this product at all? What do you think about it? And if you use any Tatcha products, let me know what you love down in the comment section, of course. And with that being said, I love you guys and I will see you in the next video. Don't forget to check out my beauty products reviews playlist because, hey, I got some good reviews in there, and I really have fun reviewing products. So if you're new to my channel and you haven't watched that, be sure to do that. All right, love you guys. Bye.